Dobrý den. In this video, I have some intellectually disheveling content to share with you. In part one, see the world with brand new eyes through a brand new language different from the English. And in second part, I would like to show you how beautiful and mysterious Czech Republic looks like, especially its northeastern border, where the Maginot line, the Czech Maginot line is. You will see. So, in part one, you will discover the four main characteristics or pillars of the Czech language. In what aspect might Czech antipodally differ from English? Ano, m'averti, on vaut deux. With first, the two varieties of modern Czech. Second, the fact that Czech uses three genders. Third, the fact that something called declension is applied to nouns, bez, adjectives, zlý, pronouns, můj, and numerals, jeden. And four, the fact that our verbs, běhat, pít, dělat, are regularly submitted to conjugation, as in Latin, in French, in German, in Italian. And in part two, of course, as I said, I will offer you some breathtaking views of the Czech environment, or what you can expect if you dare and visit my country. By the way, do you know why do we call Czechs Czechs? And do you know why Bohemia is called Bohemia? Let me know below, prosím. So my inspiration for this splendid video was first Wikipedia, second a book by Karel Tahal called A Grammar of Czech as a Foreigner Language, and my wonderful, beautiful one-month holiday in Czech Republic. Holiday which ended today as I am working and therefore living in Paris, France, completely smothered by French language, culture, people, customs, food, and mentality. Ach jo. So my antidote is to bring forward Czech language, Czech culture, Czech people, Czech food, Czech mentality, and Czech attitude to you. I'm so patriotic. So first point, standard Czech versus colloquial Czech. One of the most salient traits in Czech language is that there is a coexistence of two aspects, varieties of Czech. First, the standard Czech, spisovná čeština, which means correctly spoken and written Czech, and the vernacular, or common, or colloquial Czech. The main vernacular is based on the vernacular of Prague, but it's used throughout the whole territory, including Silesia and Moravia. Example. Dobrý den. Shh. Oh, dobrý den. This was the standard Czech. And the colloquial one is Brejden! Brej. So yes, there is a difference. You will perhaps ask yourself, are they very different? Will I have to learn them both? Well, it depends, but in a daily life you will be confronted to both, so you will learn them automatically. Second point, the fact that Czech uses three genders as Latin. Masculinum, femininum and neutrum, as we Latinists say. Nouns denoting persons are mostly masculine or feminine, usually in accordance with their natural gender. For example, masculine. Muž, kluk, chlapec, student. Feminine. Žena, holka, dívka, studentka. Nurture. Dítě. Because dítě is not a woman yet, and it is not a man yet. It will become one day man and woman. That's why it is not logical. All the youth, the animals' youths are also not. Štěně, kotě, mládě. But, unlike in English, any other noun belongs also to one of the three grammatical genders without any logical reason. And this is the first of your mantras, which you have to keep in mind and repeat when the path to wisdom gets hard. And it will. Third, the fact that something called declension is applied to nouns, adjectives, pronouns, and numerals. Because Czech is an inflectional language. And this is the second mantra you will use when the way to wisdom gets tough, and it will. I'm a very good motivational teacher, by the way. So Czech is an inflectional language with highly developed declensions of before mentioned word classes. And the most salient manifestation of the inflectional character of Czech is the category of case. Or I should say cases, because they are seven. Nouns, bez, adjectives, zlí, pronouns, můj, and numerals, jeden, are inflected. Not infected, inflected. Their forms are changed in accordance with their syntactic functions. And this type of inflection is called declension. As in English, we, us, they, them. So seven cases: nominative, genitive, dative, accusative, vocative, locative, and instrumental. Don't unsubscribe, not yet. This is not the worst part. The nominative case is the lexical entry in dictionaries and vocabularies. So its syntactic function is basically that of a subject. So when I say muž, žena, dítě, they are all in the nominative case. What would happen if you put them in the vocative case? Ženo, muži, dítě. See? Slightly different. Fourth point. The fact that our verbs dělat, běhat, pít, učit se are submitted to conjugation. Czech is an inflection language with no logic and highly developed conjugations of verbs, as in já jsem, ty jsi, on je. In English, as you see, it's also different, but the Czech goes further. My jsme, vy jste, oni jsou. So now you know what to expect. These four pillars will be your ever-growing hurdles. Motivation. So be a Gary. Do not give up the learning, but you can give up thumb. You will be very soon initiated in the arcana of the Czech language. A mystery. Very few are chosen to be on this path. So come, I will lead you. And don't forget why Czechs are Czechs and why Bohemia is Bohemia. Můj zlý pes.
Ty jeden? Dobrý den.
So sorry. And have a look. The Maginot Line. The Czech Maginot Line. Brzy na shledanou.